It is time for Beckett's from China. But before we're going to take a closer look at the stick itself, let's take a closer look at what comes inside the package. It comes with not a manual, no. It comes with a little booklet. Here you can see what kind of things are on it. Really nice, pretty basic. Some little extra buttons for if you have any problems or do of wear, you can just swap them out. It only comes with a power cable. And here is where it's going to get really interesting, because the power supply is built inside, and it's very unique because the first time I've ever seen it. It has a high quality long flat HDMI. This is the first time I'm getting one. VGA cable, if you want to hook it up to your CRT monitor or you want to use it on an old LCD monitor, you can use it VGA style. But about the sound, it's very simple. It's got a very loud little speaker inside, so you don't need to worry about that. And then USB cable, and this one, they have told me that you can hook it up to your Xbox 360 and PS3 for just using it like in a stick, like an arcade stick. So that's something we're going to find out later. So let's take a close look at the stick. All right, let's take a close look at the layout of the buttons. They did some changes if you compare it with the other versions. First of all, we got the 6-button. There are some 8-button versions, but I don't prefer it anymore because you don't need it for the Pandora itself. And we got a play 1 and 2. This is for adding a coin and pressing start. So it's more like a 2-in-1 button. We got a little button, and this is what I find very convenient. You can press it and go back to the main menu straight away. And the right and second play got the same button layout. Let's take a close look at the quality of the stick and the buttons. The stick itself, really clickish, but this is what I call a wiggle stick. It's so loose. I'm not a big fan of it, but maybe it plays very well. The buttons itself, feel decent, but not the best. Not a Samba button. Same for the smaller buttons, same quality. So yeah, let's take a look. All right, let's take a close look at the back. Here we can find the speaker that is built in the Pandora. This is what makes it really unique. The power supply is inside the Pandora, and I'm guessing it's the same 12 volt, 3 milliamp that they're always using for the Pandoras for powering it up. Basic, very basic, and it's like a quality on and off switch. And we can still use a power supply, so that is really weird. So maybe we're going to open it up someday and check it out what it is. HDMI, VGA, audio out, little scroll wheel for easy adjusting the volume. We got a setting buttons for going in the setting, and this is for adjusting every game for difficulty and coin entry and that kind of stuff. And the USB connector, so we can just use the stick on a console, so they told me. All right, people, we are back with some gameplay. The Pandora 6S, no Wicked intro this time. Let's scroll a little bit through the game list. And the first thing that I'm noticing, what did they improve? How do you say this in English? In alphabetic order. So, this is way easier to search your game. Wow, this is one big improvement. So if you want to search for Mortal Kombat, just go to the M and we can just easily search and play the games. Because that was really a pain in the ass with the other ones. Everything was just mixed up. And the only thing you could do was remember the numbers or write them down for your favorite games. There are some Pandora sticks that that is able to make a favorite list. But I don't find it very easy to use. So, yeah. Overall, I am very happy that they did this. Finally, categorizing everything like it should be. The Pandora 6S, it got more games. What you already can see, it got the same menu. So I'm thinking it's running on the same hardware specs. But I'm not knowing for sure. I'm just guessing, but I'm not surprised with these products that they're just using the same mainboard, but finally tweaking the software a little bit and adding more stuff. What you can expect is very simple. You can expect a lot of homebrew games, a lot of hacks, and then it's your question, are you waiting for it? Well, I can enjoy some of them, but I personally prefer to play the old and original rules. And I'm going to do a little bit quick scrolling through the lists. Alright, almost at the end, 139 pages. You know what? I'm just going to hold this. So you know what kind of stuff is on this thing. All right, let's do some gameplay. And the first game we are going to play is Street Fighter. And the reason is because this is a very high graphical game. So this is a very nice test to test out if it's even going to work on the Pandora. All right, let's see. How is the stick responding? You remember I'm saying there was a wiggle stick, and I love the wiggle stick. I really love it because it's playing very nice, response very good. This is a really awesome beat 'em up. The Punisher! But I think this one is almost on every stick you can think of. I want the barrel. I want the pizza. Even making the effort and putting it on. Final conclusion about the Akuma Street Fighter stick. I really love this layout. It's really nice and I'm very pleased to have this in the collection. About the Pandora Box 6S. Is it a big improvement of the previous version? I don't think so. It got more games, that is a big plus side of it. It got Mortal Kombat, I found it this time, but it is running really horrible. I was not surprised that it didn't fix it. But why add something that is not working correctly? So is it perfect? No. I really love the layout and I'm a big Akuma Street Fighter fan, so that's the reason why I ordered one. The lighter feature is really neat and that is what I really love about it. It's quite heavy this time, really heavy, so it feels also like a real quality stick. And I've noticed there are a lot of little rubber feet under it, so it's staying very stable. Overall, very pleased with the Pandora 6S. What I really love to mention out, and this is something that is very important, it's not full HD. So that's the reason I captured from my screen, from my television, and not from my capture card, because my Elgato was not recognizing it. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more awesome videos. See you next time. Bye bye.
Hi fellow YouTubers, I want to thank you for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Yes, and you also can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, yeah, don't give a shit about Twitter. But Instagram, I make pretty picture and I send on Instagram. So yeah, follow me.